Morning, boys and girls. It's Mrs. Sutton here. So the other day I had you do a Google slide presentation just looking at what it means to be a responsible digital citizen when you're online. Just kind of that idea of maybe thinking before you post or you comment, but really taking a look at how social media just within the past few years has really become a part of many of our worlds. I do have to say that this presentation that you're doing this year, I think is going to take its own kind of twists and turns, just given the fact that now we're relying so heavily on technology. So I'm curious to see your responses this year compared to maybe my students last year, again, just under the circumstances that we're in right now. One thing I want to stress with this, that it, what I'm showing you here on my desktop, it is what's called a HyperDoc. All that means, if you've never used a HyperDoc, it's kind of similar to what I asked you to do earlier this week. You're using a Google Slides format, but within that, you're going to have videos embedded. There might be some tasks. There could be definitely some notes down here at the bottom. Like I've already mentioned, you always want to check out the notes down there. A HyperDoc is meant to be more interactive, whereas usually at Google Slides, you might just present something, you give your information, and that's that. This is meant to be a little bit more interactive. It's so important that you stick to the Google Slide schedule that I give you. I noticed yesterday when I posted the digital citizenship, I say that 10 times fast, the digital citizenship Google Slides. There were a few of you in each of the classes, you immediately turned it in. I was actually asking you to pace yourself and do a little bit Monday. Then you had to watch your technology on Monday and then record your findings on Tuesday. So I cannot stress that enough, that when I do assign slides, I would ask that you stick to that schedule, please. And thank you. So going through the presentation here, we kick it off with one of my favorite TV shows, which I've definitely been watching. I actually like to watch Friends right before I take my power nap in the afternoon. But there's a video clip here. But we're looking at the art of argument. It's that idea that when you focus on a topic and you want to share your thoughts or feelings, you have to look at both sides of an argument first. So taking a look at this teaching point, again, this is from Writer's Workshop, but I am not going to read from my script, haha. But all this is asking you is just to look at both sides of an argument and to kind of suspend your judgment. We all go into things with our own kind of preconceived notions, what we think things are, what we think is right, what we think is wrong. So I'm going to ask that right now, if you're like, I'm so for social media, or you're like, I'm so against it, you actually have to remain neutral and look at both sides. So in slide number three here, here's our guiding question for the next 2 weeks or so. The question is, does social media have a negative impact on today's youth? When I say youth, I'm talking about your age. I'm talking about maybe upper elementary, but we're really focusing on middle school, so grades 5 through 8, and the impact that social media does have, for better or for worse. We're going to first kind of take a look at the, I believe it's the pros to social media, but also it kind of talks about how people interact with it, what the uses are for that, and what it's kind of doing to society. So if you take a look, you've got a political cartoon, and this is what I mean by a HyperDoc. You'll see that here's the cartoon, and then down here I'm asking you to respond. Here's a video about whether or not you're living an Insta-lie, and so you have to watch the video but also respond in the text box. So I would ask that as far as the schedule goes, just this week with this HyperDoc, I'm going to post the whole presentation. But I'd ask that on Wednesday, you focus on slides 1 through 6, and then on Thursday, complete slides 7 and 8. And then finally on Friday, slide number 9, I've added that. That's new this year. It's something that we actually would have discussed in class, but I'm going to ask you to actually take a side after you've looked at both the pros and the cons to social media and their impacts on young people. I can't stress that enough, though. I do need you to follow the schedule here. I am planning on doing at some point a Google Meet with you. I'll have to stagger that. Obviously, we've got to plan it out so it doesn't conflict with any other classes that you might be doing that. And it wouldn't be something that's required. It's just something as we get a little bit further into the HyperDoc and we get a little bit further into writing, if you're looking for some guidance and feedback. I would still ask you at this time, if you do have any questions as you're going through the slides, that you just reach out to me via email. That's definitely the easiest. So again, follow the schedule, please, on the Art of Argument. I'm asking that on Wednesday, you look at and focus on slides 1 through 6. And then on Thursday, you would focus on slides 7 and 8. And then on Friday, just completing slide number 9. I'll also be posting a writer's notebook prompt. I'm going to do that every Wednesday and Friday, just so we can get into some little bit of a routine here. You can write a few sentences, you can write a page. Again, you can do that in your writer's notebook, or you can also do that on the digital notebook that I saw some of you created. And please, please, please keep reading. That's so important. Yesterday, I started a book called House Arrest. Ironic, I know. And I'm actually almost done with it. I'll finish it today. Don't be that impressed, though. It's in verse. So it's in poetry and lines and stanzas, and it goes really quick. But I would ask that you try to read every day. I'll also be posting on Classroom just to kind of keep in touch with you guys. We'll do some flip grids just to stay in touch with each other. But I hope you're all doing well. Again, this is your HyperDoc that we'll be working on over the next couple of weeks. Email me with any questions. Talk to you soon, guys. Bye.